This is primarily what we are talking about is Empower 133 and what it did. It compared atezolizumab in chemotherapy versus chemotherapy in extensive stage small cell lung cancer. Table of content. So we'll talk a bit about small cell lung cancer, incidence and prevalence again in few slides, treatment guidelines, treatment options, the unmet need, the recent development. Not much, but whatever it is there, little, yes, now it is, looks like we do have some options. Empower 133 study and some of the trial which already we have result and where it stands as far as Empower 133 is concerned. Starting with the background, very fast growing tumor. Traditionally taught to us that if you have a fast growing tumor, they respond to chemotherapy. That's again very true for this tumor. But again, another aspect of this tumor is it responds like lymphoma, but comebacks like, you know, some other tumor which we don't see otherwise. That it's an example that tumor may respond very well, but they come back. And again, after that, when they come back, we do really have a very limited treatment options and they don't respond to subsequent treatment very well. There is early metastasis, meaning almost 2/3 of the patient has metastatic disease. Median age is around 65 years and only almost 2 to 3% of the patients are never smoker. Targeted therapy, they haven't explored a lot, but none of them looks like has any activities. But I need to concede these are, most of them are non-specific targeted therapy, which has been tried. In future, let's see if we can get some targeted therapy which works on the target which we have with small cell. It accounts almost 10 to 15% of the lung cancer. And if you see that overall, if you take a small cell lung cancer, then 5-year survival is around 2%. If we go by for the staging for small cell lung cancer, this is the same thing we're taught when I was doing my fellowship. Limited stage disease, extensive stage disease. There is some concept of very limited stage disease, which has an implication that what kind of local therapy we will be giving in that situation. Otherwise, extensive stage, small cell lung cancer, definition remains the same, which we had almost 20 years back. We do have ISLC guideline for staging for non-small cell lung cancer, but I hardly meet a clinician who uses this staging in their clinical practice. By and large, the limited stage and extensive stage small cell lung cancer is something which is commonly used, and primarily we decide treatment based on that. I do concede, in a very limited disease or a small disease, yes, the ISCLC staging becomes important, and in those situations, if you think surgery as an option, you do select patients based on that T1, T2 disease, if it is N0, and then try to think of, can you do surgery? But if I remember in last 15 years, maybe 2 or 3 patients, which I have seen getting operated at our center, suggesting they are very far and few, but important to remember at the back of our mind. Overall Indian scenario, again, 2/3 patients extensive stage disease, almost 3/4 patients extensive stage disease, and 1/4 being a limited stage disease in our practice. If you take the treatment, surgery do have some option, and I need to emphasize, remember, very few patients, but good to remember, sometimes it is useful. Otherwise, in patients receive radiotherapy plus chemotherapy, or extensive stage disease, the patient they receive chemotherapy, or in this today's time, chemotherapy plus minus immunotherapy. Prophylactic cranial irradiation in limited stage disease, yes, it is very important. In extensive stage disease, we are not so sure that we should be giving, but yes, this remains an option in case the response is good and the patient doesn't have cranial disease. In the past decade, if we see the progress which has been made in small cell lung cancer, and I'm sure all of us will agree, there is hardly any real treatment option which has developed in last few decades, maybe that is since 1985, when we had etoposide and platinum for the treatment. So we do have some other treatment, which again is important to remember, but again, which has a limited activity, irinotecan, docetaxel, paclitaxel, topotecan, gemcitabine, temozolomide. I've used all of them in our practice, and I'm sure in the audience, most of us, we have used in our practice all these treatment options. Some patients do benefit, but majority they don't. Treatment in scenario in India, small cell lung cancer being a systemic disease is treated primarily with chemotherapy, plus radiotherapy in limited stage disease, and in extensive stage disease they are treated with chemotherapy alone, and that primarily etoposide platinum. Irinotecan plus platinum is also used, but not so popular in our practice. There is a unmet need for more efficacious treatment, and that will be understatement. We do know it has been there for quite some time, and if we see 5-year overall survival, it is around 8% or 10% that we can see overall for small cell lung cancer. In an Indian scenario, there is some publication, and it suggests that 2-year survival is around 6% for limited stage disease and 2% for extensive stage disease in this group of patients. Response rate, if you take a nutshell for this small cell lung cancer, extensive stage disease, response rate good, varying from 70% to 84%. Progression-free survival 6 months, not exciting. Overall survival 10 months, again not exciting. And 5-year survival around 2%, again not exciting. So absolutely there is a huge unmet need in treatment for small cell lung cancer. If you see the treatment challenge, and this shows that how we have by and large failed in whatever we have tried. So we got approval for etoposide platinum, that is carboplatinum, in 1990s, and subsequently for last 20 years or more, whatever has been tried till now in small cell lung cancer till recently, it looks like it doesn't work in this tumor. If you see latest development, and what we can see in latest development, these are all checkpoint inhibitors. Since March 2015, where we had ipilimumab based therapy, then we had a combination with nivolumab plus ipilimumab, then we have pembrolizumab monotherapy, then we had atezolizumab monotherapy, then we have pembrolizumab maintenance, then pembrolizumab monotherapy, then we do have now atezolizumab in combination with chemotherapy as a treatment. So there has been now some progress in this area as far as the treatment outcome is concerned, and that has led to more discussion for this disease in recent times. Now, what is the rationale for combining this chemotherapy with a checkpoint inhibitor? I think so. We have seen this slide so many times. The rationale remains the same, similar for what we have in non-small cell lung cancer, and that's the reason this has been explored in small cell lung cancer also. And we always thought that small cell lung cancer, we may have higher tumor mutation burden, and maybe immunotherapy should work far better. But let us see the result as we go by. Rationale for Empower 133. There has been little progress in small cell lung cancer, as we discussed earlier. Extensive stage small cell lung cancer, they respond very well to chemotherapy. And that's the reason for the same basis for biology. It was thought that if we combine checkpoint inhibitor to chemotherapy, we may have synergistic activity and outcome may improve in these patients. This was the trial design for Empower 133. This was a pivotal study. Extensive stage small cell lung cancer was selected based on veterans criteria. They were chemo-naive patients, good performance status. Stratification was gender, ECOG performance status, and brain metastasis. And almost 403 patients were included in this study with an expansion cohort of 100 for Chinese expansion cohort. Atezolizumab 1200 milligram Q3 weekly was given with etoposide carboplatinum for 4 cycles, followed by atezolizumab as maintenance. And they were compared with etoposide carboplatinum for 4 cycles, followed by nothing in these patients. And that was placebo to ensure that we have a comparative arm where similar therapy has been given. Patient had a co-primary endpoint of PFS and overall survival, secondary endpoint of overall response rate, duration of response, 6 and 12 months of progression-free survival for these patients, and 12 and 24 months of overall survival. Coming to radiotherapy in Empower 133, and this is always important to remember that we always talk about PCI in extensive stage small cell lung cancer, but this trial reiterates that as when we are excited about it, we use far and few. only out of 400 plus patients, 44 patients received PCI. We also talked about consolidative thoracic radiotherapy, which was not permitted, but again, there were 3 patients who had received this therapy in this study. Atezolizumab was given in combination with etoposide with 4 cycles of chemotherapy. And why the 4 cycles of chemotherapy was chosen? This is because of the study which has suggested that 6 cycles may be similar to 4 cycles. We know for sure that this is true in non-small cell lung cancer patients, but it appears there is a decent data to suggest that 4 cycles may be similar to 6 cycles. If we take NCCN guidelines, it also suggests 4 to 6 cycles of chemotherapy as a standard treatment in the past. So that's a fair choice as far as the standard arm is concerned, and also the combination for atezolizumab is concerned. Coming to primary and secondary endpoint, which we talked about, there was co-primary endpoint and quite a few secondary endpoint in the study. Coming to the results, these were the baseline characteristics, which appears to be well-balanced for age, gender, smoking history, where the patient came from, performance status, brain metastasis at the baseline, liver mets at the baseline, and SLD of the target lesion at the baseline, meaning what was the combined size of those lesions. This is overall survival, and as what we can see, that yes, overall survival did improve in the patients receiving atezolizumab with chemotherapy as compared to chemotherapy, and the improvement was in the median for around 2 months. What was relatively striking was that at 12 months, the survival improved from 38.2% to 51.7%, which in this tumor is exciting because in this tumor, this kind of difference has not been seen in the past with all the various therapy which has been used. The hazard ratio was 0.7 with p-value being significant. So this was the positive study for as far as the overall survival is concerned. Coming to a progression-free survival, as we can see in any immunotherapy trial, that always remains a bit tricky, but it did improve progression-free survival, which was statistically significant. And considering that there were two primary endpoints, so PFS was better. That's why subsequently there was an analysis for overall survival in this study. Overall response rate were similar in both the arms. And this is one situation which we see more and more in tumor, where the response rates are really already high, suggesting that yes, whatever additive effect was primarily because it sustained the responses and sustained the disease control in a group of patients who had already responded to the treatment. Subgroup analysis, and this is the forest plot, suggesting that by and large, all the subgroup, there was a trend towards improvement in the survival in these group of patients, except for patients with brain mets, very small number, 35. Not sure why it should have been other way around, but having said that, it looks like in most of those subgroup, there was a trend towards improvement in survival when immunotherapy was added. Safety profile, and what we see here with the exposure of chemotherapy similar being in both the arms, the treatment-related grade 3 and grade 4 adverse event was similar. Treatment-related serious adverse event were similar. And adverse event leading to withdrawal from atezolizumab as compared to placebo was similar, a bit higher in patient receiving atezolizumab. Nothing which was very striking or which we get very concerned about. But we all do know that checkpoint inhibitor, they do have a class effect as far as the side effects are concerned. And that is seen in almost any trial when we add checkpoint inhibitor in these patients. In summary, what we can see that as far as this study was concerned, comparing atezolizumab with chemotherapy versus chemotherapy, where 4 cycles chemotherapy was given, the PFS was better with hazard ratio 0.77 with p-value being significant. And that's the reason why OS analysis was done. Again, it was a significant improvement from improving from 10.3 months to 12.3 months as far as the median is concerned. But we do know later the curve separated further, and that's the reason hazard ratio was better, that is 0.70 with p-value being significant. 12 months overall survival was striking. We need to see this data more carefully as it comes, as we get more data later, that how many patients we had get the sustained response after many years as what we have seen in non-small cell lung cancer. This result has been adopted by many of the guidelines, and here just I'm showing two of them, NCCN and European Medicine Agency, which has adopted that yes, this drug combination should be considered one of the treatment options in small cell lung cancer patient with extensive stage disease, showing you the guideline and what we can see here, that a patient has not having brain mets, a poor performance status because of disease, or good performance status patient, then systemic therapy plus checkpoint inhibitor becomes important. Poor performance status patient, which is not because of disease, one needs to individualize the treatment. As far as the patient with brain mets is concerned, if the brain mets is asymptomatic, systemic therapy followed by radiotherapy becomes important. And symptomatic patient, whole brain radiotherapy will take a priority in this situation. And as we can see, the guideline also suggests that chemotherapy remains as one of the treatment options. But yes, adding immunotherapy is beneficial for our patient. These are the some of the trial which is we do have a result. So we know Empower 133, a positive study, Checkmate 451, a negative study, Caspian, a positive study, Keynote 604, a positive study, Meru, a negative study. So in this situation, we have at least three studies which is positive, and I think so it will be interesting to see how we put these three options in our practice and choose one of them for our use. As far as these three are concerned, all three is available in India. So it will be a bit tricky to see how we will be going to use those treatments in our clinical practice. Summary, Empower 133 led to showing that immunotherapy plus chemotherapy works. So for me, what it does, reassures us that as a concept in small cell lung cancer, immunotherapy does have a role. We may keep on debating how much it improves the outcome, but I think so there is no debate that sometimes you do have a one or two study positive, and then you have multiple study negative with a similar concept. That is not the case as far as the immunotherapy and small cell lung cancer is concerned. It looks like multiple studies getting positive, suggesting that immunotherapy does add value for patients as far as treatment is concerned in extensive phase small cell lung cancer. Atezolizumab combination with chemotherapy becomes one of those treatment options in this setting, and the key guidelines suggest that this should be considered one of those options. Its combination has a superior survival benefit as compared to chemotherapy as far as the median is concerned, and also as far as the landmark analysis for 1 year survival is concerned in this setting. Sure, we all want to know what can be the biomarker to suggest when to use this drug, and that is a million or billion dollar question. There was a very interesting question by Dr. Seventy for TMB. I am sure you all want to know, can we have any of these biomarker to be used at multiple places, including small cell, to select those patients whom we can give it? And this slide was given by Roche to show, so that I need to show you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.